MashaAllah, Sheikh Yaver is blessed with the ability to speak 5 languages, and this has helped him to instill leadership fundamentals amongst many an organization. Sheikh Yaver Beg, as he prefers to say, is a student of Islamic studies and is a much sought after speaker at Islamic events. He is also widely respected for the many well-researched and informative public talks which he delivers on a wide range of subjects such as Islam and science, social etiquette of a Muslim, and other matters of spirituality. A personality who values competence, openness, and value-based professionalism, our respected speaker and guest this evening works as a life coach and mentor of prominent family businesses in India and South Africa. His unique style of lectures, where he injects Islamic doctrine into key areas of corporate management and blends Eastern values with Western systems, has been lauded and appreciated by many national and global organizations and audiences who have been fortunate to listen to him. We are indeed happy to note that a growing number of local-based companies have also sought his services and alhamdulillah benefited from his training sessions. Without any further delay, it is my honor and privilege to call upon our respected guest to speak to you on the subject, the purpose of life. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi.
Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. As-salatu was-salamu ala al-anbiya'i wal-mursaleen. وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. ما بعد، my dear respected elders and brothers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Purpose here today is not to lecture to you, but to remind myself, and in the process, remind you that a day will come upon each one of us, without a doubt. A day will come upon each one of us, about which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فلولا إذا بلغت الحلقوم وأنتم حينئذ تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه منكم ولكن لا تبصرون فلولا إن كنتم غير مدينين ترجعونها Allah said a day will come when the breath will be stuck in the throat. إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُومُ The breath will be stuck in the throat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and on that day you will be standing there looking on. فَأَنْتُمْ حِينَ إِذٍ تَنْظُرُونَ SubhanAllah, this is a time, this is a day, and this is an event that many of us have seen for ourselves. We have been in the presence of people in their last moments of their lives, when they were struggling for breath, when they were no longer aware of who was around them, when they were no longer concerned about the very people for whom they dedicated their lives. At that point in time, they did not know that those people came with them. Those same people who would probably have been, would have liked to do whatever they can do to help them, are completely helpless. وَأَنْتُمْ حِينَ أَذِنْ تَنْظُرُونَ Allah says, you are standing there and watching. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us His word of hope. وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْكُمْ وَلَكِنْ لَا تُبْصِرُونَ Allah says, but we are close to them. You do not see us. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the bayan of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenges those who stand today in opposition to the hakam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah says, Tarjiunaha in kuntum sadiqin. Allah says, you thought so powerful, then return that breath. You think you are so powerful, then return that breath. Give them the life back. The malak mouthing the life, remove money from the attack button. I'll mention this in another place in the Quran. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions people who deny the resurrection. Who deny one day we will be resurrected to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَالُوا إِذَا ضَلَلْنَا فِي الْأَرْضِ إِنَّا لَفِي خَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ بَلْ هُمْ بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّهِمْ كَافِرُونَ قُلْ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ الَّذِي وُكِّلَ بِكُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَيْكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ الله said this. وَقَالُوا إِذَا ضَلَلْنَا فِي الْأَرْضِ إِنَّا لَفِي خَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ It's possible that after we have died and we have become dust and we have become one with the soil and the earth, that we are going to be created anew? How much? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that question is a denial of the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In kufr,
about the meeting of Allah, the denying the meeting of Allah. What is the meaning of response to that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks his Nabi to give to that people?
Allah says, you will die. Whether you believe it, مَوْتِ الَّذِي مُكِّلَ بِكُمْ مَلَكٌ has been set upon ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ بِكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ and he will tell and he will bring you back to your Rabb. You will return to your Rabb. My brothers and elders, this will come. We have seen this day come upon many who have gone before us. And that day will come upon you and it will come upon me. Allah knows best who will go first and Allah knows best who will go next. But we all, they will come when in this very masjid, inshaAllah, somebody will stand here and make an announcement and say that we just got information that Yawar Beg passed away. Make dua for it. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned three kinds of people for that day. For that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned three kinds of azwajun salat.
فما إن كان من المقربين
May Allah take us among them.
فروح وريحان وجنة نعيم وما إن كان من أصحاب اليمين فسلام لك من أصحاب اليمين وما إن كان من المكذبين الضالين فنزل من حميم وتصلية جحيم إن هذا لهو حق اليقين فسبح باسم ربك العظيم
Three kinds of people. المقربون The people who are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as-sabiquna al-awwalun. The people who are the earliest and the fastest to respond to Islam. And remember, as-sabiquna al-awwalun is not restricted only to the Sahaba. Because Allah said, kullatum min al-awwalin wa qalilum min al-akhirin. So there are people in the akhirin also, not a lot of them, but some of them who will be joined with and who will be included among the as-sabiquna al-awwalun. And then the people Ashabul Yameen, the people who will get their records in their right hand. May Allah make all of us among Allah. And then those who denied Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Mukazzibeen wa Dhalleen. May Allah protect us from and keep us. Allahumma la ta'jalna ma'alhum. And that is where the importance of and maqsad the creations of our being. That is the reason why this is so important, my brothers and elders. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned two things about the reason why He created us. In one place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala His reason created us as individuals. And in another place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned His creating this ummah, our collective reason for creating us as the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ We have not created So the individual purpose of creation is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and to do nothing but worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this ayah is with regard to all of mankind, it's not only for the Muslims. Allah created all of insan, for some do it, but we cannot worship for 24/7. Anything other than the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we are not fulfilling this purpose. How can we worship for 24 hours of the day? We know. And it is only that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does us any hukum which is, it would be unfair. Give us an order, the order is impossible to complete or to obey. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said fly and he did not give us wings and we cannot fly, how are we going to fly? See, Allah, I want to fly, but you know, I am incapable of flying. Allah does give us orders like this, which are impossible to obey. So when Allah said, where is the innamal amal ubin? So what is ibadah? Ibadah is any action that is done with the expectation of reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With the expectation of reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I give some money in charity because I want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I ask please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I wake up in the night and I pray from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are three other conditions which must be fulfilled as we all know. One, which is intrinsic, for example, I want, but because people are non-Muslim, I decide to give them pork because I like to eat pork. You want to feed people, but you feed them stuff, you say, no, but they eat, they may eat, they may not eat, that's not your problem, it's not your job to them that. Similarly, therefore, the deed has to be in accordance with the sharia Secondly, the intention of the deed has to be only and only for the pleasure of Allah. Al-Ikhlas Niyya. And what is the dalil for that? Allah said, Wa'il Musallin. Al-Fatihim Sahur. They do the salah to people. Salah itself is according to Sharia. Nobody can deny the Sharia that salah is not according to the Sharia. But the intention, the niyya of the salah is not to please Allah. The niyya of the salah is to please the people. Is to get a name with Subhanallah. What a beautiful recitation. Oh Subhanallah, what beautiful khushu. Look at this man, he is standing in salah. Whenever he recites the Quran, he is crying. Oh mashallah, mashallah. Now, if you are reciting the Quran and you are crying and this is spontaneous, this happened because of the azmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart, it's a different matter. If you are crying to show that I have got this great khushu and this ta'alluq and this is shirk. This is riya. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said very clearly, he said, this is riya. To show people. So even though recitation of the Quran is intrinsically in itself, it's a good deed and worthy of, and we know all the hadith with regard to the amount for, you know, I won't tell you all those, you are aware of them, but my point is that even though the action in itself is good, but because the niyya does not have ikhlas, that is not acceptable before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third condition for a deed to be acceptable, first condition sharia, second condition niyyah, third condition is that the deed must be in accordance with the sunnah of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we do a deed which is outside the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if we do something which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not do, he did not interaction and we do that and we think that we are going to get reward from Allah, then this is a mistaken impression. It's not possible. It has to, the deed has to be in accordance with the sunnah of the sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So alhamdulillah, if these three things are there, but how can we make our entire life, wake up in the morning, with what intention? With the intention to wake up for tahajjud inshallah. You go make wudu, you come and stand, you pray tahajjud. Deed to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, Quran, wait for Salatul Fajr, go to the masjid. Wait for Salatul Fajr, pray Fajr. That this gives me strength in order to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order to do the work of the deen, in order to look after my family and so on, all of which is part. And then you help your family in the house, and then you go to work. And when you go to work, you ensure that the kind of work you do is in line or not against the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You work sincerely to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to whom you are accountable, not because your boss is. You go and you work in a way and your whole intention is, I must present Islam to the people who are with me. Working please my boss. I am working so that people will say, he is a Muslim, mashallah, my best employee is a Muslim. You want your employers to think and say, when I am hiring, I would like, because they are the best people for me to work with. They are the most conscientious. They are the most quality conscious. They are the most sincere people because they fear me, they fear Rabbum, whole day in work goes like that. Come back home, house, live in a beautiful manner with your family, Why? Because it pleases Allah. That not pleases Allah. Why do I smile at my wife? Because it pleases Allah. Why do I smile to my children? Because it pleases Allah. Why